In this last version of Polygon.js, you can now create audio nodes, and those nodes are going to allow you to import MP3 or WAV files to import your own audio, or you can create synthesizers to generate your own sound, and you can add effects as well, like reverb, chorus, or pitch shift. And that will allow you to augment your experience when you generate triggered sounds based on some user events. So let's see how this works. So if I start with a new scene and I create a positional audio node, then you see it's going to create an audio listener as well, which is necessary to hear the sound. And this positional audio can be the source of a sound and can be anywhere in your scene. So the first thing we see is that it has an error. So if we middle click to it, it says invalid audio node. And it already has an audio node inside it, which is a file node. So let's go and see that. When I look at it, I can see that one also has an error and failed to load URL. And that's because there is no URL to load any file from. So let's start by using one of the presets, so this one. And we can hear sound right away. So one thing we can start and do is add effect to it. So let's play some. And I'm going to relay that to out. And if I go back to instead of looking at the file, I'm going to look at the out. And now I can start, let's say, to put some reverb or some pitch shift. And if I restart the sound, you should hear there is a difference that is perceptible. And you can affect those parameters of each effect as the sound is playing. And I can also add my own sound. So if I create a synthesizer and I plug that to the out, now this has an error which is saying that it needs an envelope node. So I'm just going to create this envelope node. And now I don't hear any sound because the synthesizer needs to be triggered by something. So let's start by triggering it with the play instrument. And from here we can see that on top of the usual parameters, I also have a piano here. So let's open this layout a little differently so I have more space to look at it. So palm right is going to be just what I need. And as I touch the keys, I can see what the different notes of the synthesizers could do. And I can add some reverb as well here. And the notes are going to be a little different. I can also view many more nodes than the default. I can open the whole piano from very high pitch to very low pitch. But let's go back to the default. And I want to see what the name of the notes I'm playing at. So I'm just going to click here, update note from instrument, which is going to update this one. So as I touch the keys here, this note is going to be updated. That's going to be useful later to know which note to play. And so now let's see how to trigger that based on some user event. So I'm going to create an event network. And in here, I'm going to use a raycast. I'm going to try and generate a sound when I pass the mouse over the sphere. So let's create a mouse event. And I'm going to put the mouse move to the trigger. And I'm also going to put the viewer class updated so I can see a mouse, the hand cursor, when I move the cursor over the sphere, so I know that it is working. And once I have that, I can put the audio node, and I'm going to trigger once I hit something, and I will trigger the out node that we have created, and now it will play the node C1, which is quite low pitch, so I'm just going to modify that to what we had here, which is those ones are going to be easier to hear. So let's go with G4. So I select G4. I can press G with my keyboard and go to G's, and G4 is here. So now I hear that when I click on the button, and also when I touch the sphere with my mouse. So that's one way to generate sound based on user events, and there are many more ways. We can go more in depth in future videos.